Hello, my invaders. We're back playing Life is Strange, episode 2.
Two days ago, we...
Oh, if I don't win, there's all his powers.
No.
No. Oh boy, your principal's office.
Miss Price, how good of you to join us.
I'm so sorry we're late. My shift ran late at the diner, and then just sorry.
Let us proceed. One of you here is new to the Blackboard disciplinary process, and the other is all too familiar with it. Blackwell's code of conduct is built upon a foundation of mutual respect meant to foster an environment conducive to education and enrichment. With that respect,
reality check time. Yesterday did actually happen. I ditched school with Rachel Amber.
What the? Not yesterday, now it's 2 days ago.
We did start that fire. And that was after we actually agreed to run away from here. Right?
Are you paying attention to me, Chloe?
What?
Miss Price, the last time we met, an agreement was broken. Do you recall what that was?
Don't get in trouble again.
Trouble is merely the byproduct, Miss Price. What's at issue is your attitude. We agreed that you would rededicate yourself to becoming an exemplary Blackwell citizen. In the event that you were unable or unwilling to do so, we also agreed that it would become pertinent to reassess your future status at the Academy. Despite all this, you engaged in the following actions yesterday: insubordinate language. Witnesses saying you were involved in bullying made them present.
The hell I was! I stood up for that bullying.
Then how do you explain the desecration of Mr. Prescott's photography project?
Didn't say I was successful.
Yeah.
Say what you will about my daughter, but she is not a bully.
Maybe you should be talking to Drew instead of me. You know, the guy who actually did what you're accusing me of.
Mr. North's situation requires sensitivity. It will be handled separately.
And Chloe's situation is less sensitive?
Do not discuss other students' situations. We are here to discuss your daughter and her actions.
Indeed.
Principal Wells, I know this looks bad.
Thank you for your validation, Ms. Price. May I continue? With your permission.
Sorry.
And yet, even with your prodigious disciplinary record, Ms. Price, we needn't discuss any of it.
We needn't.
No, because you severed your relationship with Blackwell the minute you left school grounds without permission.
What does that mean?
It means you forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions. I have no choice but to.
What? Yesterday was all me.
Say us what now?
Based on what you've just told me, I have grounds to punish you. Are you sure what you've told me is the truth?
Yes.
This can't be the whole story. Red. Just to be clear, Miss Amber, you're sure Chloe Price didn't coerce you or
coerce her?
I'm just trying to get to the bottom of why someone like
Rachel. Oh, I think we're clear, Principal Wells. Someone like Rachel, but not my daughter.
Excuse me?
Do you have a list of students you assumed the worst about?
I'm
you
very
have
sure.
No right to treat Chloe this way. This is because she's on financial aid, isn't it?
Let's all just calm down.
After everything she's been through in the last 2 years, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Miss Price.
Mrs. Price.
Mrs. Price, I appreciate your position, but I assure you, it is only your daughter's past behavior that has led us here today.
I understand, Mr. Rose. There is no doubt that Chloe's behavior must improve. But given what we've just learned about the negative influence she is under, I hope you will allow her just one more chance.
Miss Amber, I am as surprised as I am disappointed.
I understand.
This being your first infraction in no way reduces its severity. Still, we will not be suspending you at this time. But you have squandered our trust. You will no longer be my administrative assistant for this period. And you will no longer be involved in Blackwell's performance of the test.
Sure.
So aware of our school calendar, Miss Price, I would expect fewer absences on your record.
Right. She loves that show. Since this is her first infraction.
Mr. Amber, I don't tell you how to run the district attorney's office. Please don't tell me how to run my school.
Yeah, Mr. Amber.
There's a reason we have understudies for all circumstances, accidental and deliberate. I'm sure you're understudy.
Victoria Chase.
No.
Yes, I'm sure Victoria Chase will do fine.
That is
what is that, Miss Price?
Chloe is upset for her friend, but we are both grateful that she is not going to be unduly blamed for what happened.
There is plenty of blame to go around. Chloe's future at Blackwell will be discussed next, unless you add something to add first, Miss Price. Chloe may not have been the mastermind of yesterday's events. It was, as I prefaced, the proverbial last straw. In light of your many past transgressions, I have no choice but to suspend you for the rest of the year.
But it was the other girl's idea. She confessed.
And she will be punished accordingly, but that does not absolve Chloe of her responsibility. I am truly sorry it has come to this, but Chloe will have the chance for reinstatement in the fall. Her actions beginning now will be weighed heavily in that decision. Do you understand me? Both of you.
Yeah. I mean, as much as I ever do.
Chloe? We understand, Mr. Lewis.
I will have Skip Matthews escort you to clean out your locker. You may wait outside my office until he arrives. That is all. Good day, Mrs. Price, Mr. and Mrs. Amber.
Pray.
Come on, Chloe.
That's not cool.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Tim. We didn't have the job here to do that.
I didn't get the chance to introduce myself. I'm Jules.
Mrs. Price.
I'm Rose. This is James. I'm sorry we had to meet like this.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sure for you this is an unusual circumstance.
I'm trying to keep the camera straight so I don't fall. I did like
we really should be
a couple days ago.
Nice to meet you.
Yesterday actually. Because that's why the original video.
Yeah.
Camera fell out in the middle of the video.
Yeah, I see you in the apartment.
Hey Chloe. I'm supposed to walk you out.
Excuse me.
Just you and me. Hey, Skip.
You know I'm supposed to have today off, right?
Sorry, but my totally fair and impartial here at convenience to a man. I don't really care about any of this shit. So, my secret stash. Might as well grab an emergency joint right here. I love how every time someone tells me how much potential I have, it's right before saying how I'm used to Trusty keeper, my graffiti pets. You've served me well. Trusty keeper, my graffiti pets. You've served me well. Suspended for the year. It's starting to feel real. I have big plans for that this garage. Oh well. Chem is the class I hated the least. They came here for. Jackpot. Wait. What the hell? Damn it, Justin. Fuck every inch of this place. I wish I could tag it for Flora's smile. But with Skip watching me.
Bathroom. Now. Cool?
Okay. But try to make it fast, will you?
Oh, she's in the bathroom right now. Ah, I see. Tagging. Or graffiti on your feet. I have no control right now. Was like, what the heck? Like, holy crap, all that art.
Or album of graffiti.
Sheesh. I'm surprised the glory right where all that. I didn't have any control over that.
David's here. Awesome. The drugs are free here. Yeah, why didn't anyone tell me before?
Yeah, they're not. You sure do a trip out to your feet.
Three guesses whose bike this is, and they'll start with this friend. Damn. I guess I will miss one thing about this place. You still have plenty of free time to take up skateboarding again. I feel like it.
It's about damn time.
David is clearly fighting to hide her disappointment. Which, of course, just makes this worse.
I'll handle it.
Chloe, your mother and I have been talking.
Can we do this later? I don't think I can handle another fight right now.
And who do you expect to handle things for you? Your mother?
This isn't a fight, Chloe. It's a conversation. Remember that.
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat. I just need some space.
Do not use that language with your mother.
If my mother has something to say, she will say it to me.
She has. The problem is, you don't listen. Maybe if you tried listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What? Like how to have no job? Or how to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family.
kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
David, that's out of line. You weren't with us in there. Chloe was treated unfairly.
Now you're making excuses for her? Chloe needs to take responsibility.
I decide what Chloe needs, not you. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I don't want to fight. I care about your mother very much. And you too. I'd like for us to start over. What do you say?
Sure. Reset button press.
I am glad to hear it. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas, like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol.
David, do you really think now is the right time?
Joyce, please. We must be a united front.
Mom.
Chloe, I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, you saw how I was treated in there. Now you want to treat me the same way? I don't need more discipline from you. I need my mom.
I know, Chloe. And I'm sorry, but David feels...
Joyce.
We feel this is the best way to start fresh.
Let's go, Chloe. Brainstorm.
Sucks even worse than invading someone's privacy. Doing it for no reason.
You're awfully smug for someone who just got kicked out of school.
Oh, David. Chloe, I'm sorry. Can you forgive me?
I forgive you. You were under a terrible influence.
I just worry about you. There's no excuse.
Joyce? Can't start apologizing now. This will only encourage her.
That's enough out of you, David. We need to start treating each other better. And that means all of us. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
What does that mean?
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
What?
I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
Talk to me, Chloe. Tell me what you're feeling.
Everything's running smoothly. You'll see what a stable home can be like.
There is no home.
not a piece there. Chloe.
Let her go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
Which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down?
Don't know how to answer that.
This thing is a mess, but maybe I can fix it. piece will never run again, the first thing it needs is a new battery. Gusto was pretty pissed at Rachel last night. Amazing that someone I just met could have made me this angry. I wonder if I'll ever ride one of these again. What are you trying to hide under there, Cole? Here we go. Yep. Pick a billionaire.
Wow. Shitty ride drug dealer.
Think of that pro bigger. I used to love opening up the diner with Mom before school. I guess those days are now officially over.
Okay, let's cure it. I thought I'd check out another cure it. Can't leave our main character so early. Sorry about the coughing. Got a sore throat. Be a pro hijacker, screwdriver. Use it.
Damn. This thing, it's more love than I can give right now. In the meantime, maybe I can spruce it up a bit. Maybe there's another light bulb I can put in here. While a stink patch could be nice, I should probably cover over this massive hole. Probably a good idea to cover over this with something. Okay, let's see what else this trash heap has to offer. Don't want to leave yet. American Rust. Sounds about right.
just might make the perfect cover for that concert. Jealous of you than anything. Hopefully, I'll be escaping this place soon, too. Glass looks way prettier when it's broken. Wonder what else that's true for. Better head back to the truck. I do still love opening up the diner with mom before school. I guess those days are now officially over.
It's only a picnic.
Sure, this isn't what Rachel meant when she talked about going to LA to be a model. Then again, it's probably not what this person meant either. Just you and me, you tiny weirdo. This thing looks like a rusted out shopping cart. It probably drives like one too. That's if it ever does drive, which seems questionable. Still, how sweet would that be? Yeah?
Frank.
Oh. Hey, Frank. What's up?
alcohol or anything, right? Like, in general, or to you? Time for a hard-earned smoke. You're feeling good, Rubberball. Facing the trap is hard work. Time to kick back and light up. As Principal Wells eat pizza with a fork and knife. I knew there was something off about that guy. And what do we have here? You only get one chance to make a first expression. The eye sees all.
Smoke, it kills you.
Shit, I slept all day. What the hell? I wonder if it burned like this the day it happened. I miss him so much.
missed them so much.
Amazing, isn't it? I can't look away.
Sure.
Don't pretend you're not mesmerized too. See? You're so drawn to it, you don't even realize the danger.
Danger?
Fire blinds us. Just like darkness. But darkness blinds with absence. With loss.
What is fire blind with?
Beauty.
What the?
But sometimes there's a greater beauty yet to come. Fire is jealous, Chloe. It wants all the beauty for itself. That's why you need to be careful.
Careful of what?
Of getting hurt.
Two-Face. So he's Two-Face now, huh?
Great.
Just don't flip a coin, you know, don't you?
Hasn't anyone ever told you not to call this in with a lit cigarette? You could start a fire.
I don't like a creature.
So, are you going to invite me in? Or what? I love giving rides to strange drifters. Hop in. Thanks. Nothing. Just some junk that I'm lying around.
Pirate flag? A cool blue light?
Holy shit. We all seen that.
Figured it can't hurt to have the Illuminati on our side for whenever shit goes down.
Always thinking ahead. Chloe, this is incredible. I can't believe you found this mistake you already. That's the hope.
But it doesn't exactly drive yet.
We'll figure it out. And while you're at it, we're also going to need some money.
No, buy stuff. Uh-huh. Bar and money.
Holy shit. That was me. I'm so sorry. I can't believe he actually suspended you.
Really? I'd say it's like the most believable thing that's ever happened to anyone in the history of forever.
I'm just so pissed about the play.
How could they let Victoria Chase jack your role?
Because life is a tale told by the idiot, both sound and fury, signifying nothing.
Yeah, totally.
At least Rose has an idea what really went down with this last one. Shit got pretty wild.
Rachel, that was more than pretty wild. You went absolutely nuts last night.
What the hell were you thinking? I was angry. I didn't expect the whole stupid park to go whoosh.
But now you're angry too. Accessory after the fact.
Unless you tell me.
Of course, I'm no snitch. I'd be way happier going to jail than having to live at home with Dick Taylor being it. He announced his plans to move in this morning.
Oh, Chloe, that's awful. I'm so sorry. You knew we both could use
therapy. Therapy. You start.
Kick back and tell me if I'm gonna move.
Been booted from school, and I'm not entirely sure what to do about it.
You mean how to cope with your feelings of anger and disappointment?
No. I mean how to express my feelings of intense joy.
Uh-huh. Do you think you might be taking this a little too long?
You tell me. I'd say I'm exceptionally well-adjusted.
I bet my therapist's license that no one's ever called you that before.
Touché, Doc. There's this dildo with a mustache who's been dating my mom, and now he thinks he's moving in with us. Help me stop it.
That's a hard one. I'm not sure that he's really looking for candy.
Then what the hell am I talking to you for?
Just because you can't stop him doesn't mean you don't fight back. The resistance begins now.
Alright. You're going to need a new nickname to mark your enemy. What have you got? He's a step douche. Because he's inserting himself when he doesn't belong. Also, he's a douche.
Poetic.
May I also suggest stepladder?
Why stepladder?
Because he climbs on your mom every night.
Oh my god.
Pretty soon, they'll be stepping down the aisle. What the hell kind of therapist are you? Sorry, it's called shock therapy. Highly controversial.
Oi!
So, my new friend, who everyone thinks is perfect, did something bad shit fucking whatsoever. What do I do? This perfect friend of yours, who I'm assuming is also an exceptional beauty, sounds like she may have been inspired by someone new in her life. Perhaps this friend of yours, who, I reiterate, must be just stunning, needed someone in her life to teach her. How to steal the line from yuppie picnickers? How not to give a fuck. Because she was tired of having to give so many fucks all the time. That makes sense. That was actually somewhat therapeutic. Thank you. It's always a pleasure dubbing my little Chris. And now it's your turn. Tell me all about what it's like being daughter of Arcadia Bates with this famous scumbag. It sucks. Do you want? Sorry. I do that sometimes. Nah, I'm just, I don't know. Can we talk about something else?
Of course.
pretty soon this entire town will be burnt to a smoldering pile of ashes. So, you know, things are really looking up for us.
From what I've tasted of desire, I hope it goes with you. Do you think there's a point when you've been acting so much that you don't even have any personality anymore? You're just whatever you think other people want you to be. I think you have a personality. I wasn't talking about you. My dad doesn't really exist. You saw him in Wells' office. The whole thing was a performance. And now I'm starting to feel like everything in my life is bullshit. But he's still my dad. How can I make sure he'll end up with him? You couldn't be like him even if you could. You're too awesome. The fact that you believe that makes me feel better. Shit. It's playtime. Clean out my dressing room for Dick's birth. I'm not exactly the role I thought I'd be playing tonight. Oh no. Hey, I was thinking that after the show, maybe we could go do something. Just you and me. Something criminal. Criminal fun. I'm in.
Wait, you forgot your bag. It's for you. Just a little survival kit for your new life on the land. Try to save it for you.
Thank you.
Yes, this is the outfit for the episode.
Junkyard security technology. That's the one we saw with Rachel's. Thank you. somewhat of a messy theater. A throne fit for a throne. Is this it?
Have a seat.
Papadoom, huh? That's one badass name for a dog.
It's French.
Does it mean, like, tough guy or something?
Do I look like I speak fucking French?
Okay, so who is that woman?
What woman?
The one I saw coming out of your RV.
Oh yeah, I meant to introduce you. Her name is Mind Your Own Fucking Business.
Okay. Fine. Guess Rachel's dad was into bad guys.
You're the builder now?
Shit! Really?
I'm crazy. My friend Dana runs the place. We lost a lot of money.
How about you? Did you lose anything in the fire?
No. Well, I'll probably get pulled into whatever shit Dana's dealing with right now. Lately, he's been doing some stuff that I don't like. But I don't seem to have much leverage with him. But you and I have shit to discuss.
Is this about the Buck 75?
What?
The money that I owe you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I don't give a shit about that. Wait, you have it?
Give me like another week.
I wonder if I'll ever get tired of your crap. You're lucky you're the least of my problems. Open my notebook. Last page. There should be some entries for Kid named Drew. You know him?
Drew North? Yeah, he's... Oh, holy shit. That's a lot of money.
Drew looks boxy for Dana. Apparently football players eat it like candy.
That's smart. Yes. It pays well?
You go big, Fitz. Problem is, Drew owes a friend, and if not answer my calls, you know what's going on with him?
No. I never talked to him. Or his type.
No one's just a type in Christ. Anyway, here's the job. I'm taking you to Blackwell. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and meet you to pick it up. Can you handle that?
Yeah, of course, but what's in it for me?
Idiot, you still own me.
So, if I do this, then we're good?
That, and I'll do even better. I'll give you a 10% cut of the money.
Okay. Yeah, sure. I'll do it.
What's the matter?
It might be a little tough. I'm not supposed to be at 5 o'clock. I got suspended this morning.
Congratulations. It's still easier for you to go on campus than for me.
Hal?
If you can't even do this, Christ.
$100 closer to leaving Arcadia Bay with a bit of cash and the truck fixed, Rachel and I could really do it. We can leave for good. I'll do it. I'll do it.
So, we're going to suspended property. We are going to be in doo-doo!
looks like my options are to become a master lockpicker or swipe some of these keys. This room definitely isn't this way. This room definitely isn't this way.
Yeah, I'm not trying to look at the time.
What are the chances that 200 years ago, some teenager had trouble writing faces all over the brick? They understand that. From this pretentious art about the sanity, as usual. In a way, that's kind of badass. Black Wall Academy. Been serving water since never. I've been subject for the day. Better you than me, bird. Bingo. If only those keys were unsupervised. What's Samuel working on? The sprinklers? Samuel's working on the sprinklers, some damage here might get his attention. But Evan is right there. For a fresh start. Here we go. One small flight for this bird, one giant leap backward for Chloe Price.
Like, how close? Where? Oh, my eye. I'm here to save you.
If I can scare that bird far enough away, maybe Evan will see the bird that's great. Right. started. You gotta stand up the other way. For a fresh start. Here we go. Gotcha.
Perfect.
You're welcome. Just have to wait for Samuel to come up. That works. Sorry, Sam. All right, time to find Drew's room. No time like the present. Going inside, dude. You're just gonna have to let this slide.
I don't think I can. In fact, I think I have to ask you to state your official business or else vacate Blackwell property.
I hate to do this to Skip, but I've got to get inside. Maybe if I make him really uncomfortable, he'll feel guilty and let me pass.
What's my official business? You mean business, Skip? As in my business? I need to use the restroom. Glad you asked.
What? No, it's my job to ask, Moly. This feeling that you're up to something.
Wait. You talked me into letting you into the bathroom this morning, and then you tagged the entire friggin' place.
What? No.
I totally did that.
I was raking you over the coals for that. Time to go.
Or what? What are you gonna do, Skip? Because unless you're prepared to drag me off this campus, I'm going inside.
Enough. This is my job. Just go. You have never respected me. You and all your smug little classmates. I am so tired of being shit on by high school. Don't. You know what? I'm done. I'm done with the stupid running cop job. Just do whatever the fuck you want.
No, still.
We just got hurt. We just got him to quit. Holy crap, he quit. Real quick.
Which one is Drew's room? Could Elliot be Wagner if he tried? Definitely Drew's room. God. Drew's not here. Okay. If I were Drew, where would I hide my money? Holy shit, Drew. A college scholarship? No wonder you're selling your football. It looks like Mikey's been staying here with Drew. Is the money in there? All right. Guess you have to crack a four-digit code.
Hold on, I'm gonna do a little peek. Let me do a little see if you guys see.
I didn't realize Drew was this. Frank wasn't lying. So many things are shit out of my mind. At at least giving us some prospects.
Look at that. More numbers.
I wonder exactly how important 516 is to Drew.
Taking a drink break real quick. Where's good?
Plenty of possible combinations here.
I think I remember something. Oh, and there's actually not, I remember that code from the last time I played this.
Looking for your brother, but he's not here, so.
Why? Bro, we gotta go. Yesterday wasn't enough. You wanna go another round? Doesn't matter. Mike, get your stuff, let's move.
Oh my God.
Give me 1 week. You're just going to lie there? I thought football players.
Okay. Good work. Thank you, Chloe. Thank you.
I didn't do anything.
You kept my brother safe. True? You need to get to the hospital.
Best to keep the money so he doesn't kill us again.
Don't tell anyone about this, okay?
Yeah. No. No way. What? What are you going to do?
About Amy?
Man, that was insane! That's even worse.
This day has been so messed up. And that's before having to watch Victoria butcher Rachel's boy. At least I can be here for Rachel.
And we will be next time. Until then, we had a great time today, invaders. Can't believe this shit went down. The crap that went down. We fixed your car. We fixed your truck. David's moving in. Drew got beat up. What a heck of a day. Until then, until next time, invaders, Rapid Invader 24 is out.